Happy birthday, Brian. Remember when you said you didn't want a big deal and have it be all about you on your birthday this year? I didn't listen.
First time I met Gary Floater.
It's not for Gary Floater. It's for Brian's birthday.
When Brian came into this world, the announcement said, "Look who's wearing the pants in our family now." Well, soon he was wearing the shoes.
Brian, happy birthday. This is a little This Is Your Life moment, so I'm going to walk you down memory lane a little bit, just kind of get you the early Brian, the teenage Brian, and kind of get the everybody to know your mentality back then. We met at newspaper class, and we actually were talking about this band. Not a band I think we talked about a lot after that, but Little U2 and this very song, Sunday Bloody Sunday, this very video, as a matter of fact, we talked about, because Bono, in this moment, was putting the flag in the crowd and like wiggling it back and forth, and he was getting pissed because they wouldn't hold it still. But we ended up talking about that, and Rattle and Hum was out at the time, and you know, we just got into one of our very first philosophical talks, and we became friends in that newspaper class, sitting on that counter talking for hours, it seems like, about music, and of course that was a big part of our relationship, as well, and probably all of your relationships was a big deal. Then we went on that big concert run a couple of years later after both of us graduated from high school. I think it might have been your summer between high school and college. And one of the shows we went to was in Cleveland. And I don't know how much people know about your music background, but this was this is kind of where you were at back then. Obviously still finding yourself, but Little Motley Crue we saw in Cleveland. And if I remember right, that show was sold out, packed. Almost a three-hour show. They put on two encores, a pretty great show. Then we saw another show. We went to Pittsburgh and met some of your friends in Pittsburgh. This was maybe the same summer, as a matter of fact. It might have been the next summer, but I'm not sure. We ended up under the bridge in Pittsburgh. That was the day we had maybe a bottle of tequila that started full and ended empty. Such is life. But we went and we saw one of the biggest concerts I've ever seen, Metallica and Guns N' Roses, and I just remember that show because Axl Rose controlled that crowd. I think maybe a week later he ended up having his little incident in Canada, but let's move on from that. So I don't want to talk a little too much longer. We're already at the 2-minute mark. So of course the band that we probably had the most in common back then was Van Halen, your favorite band at the time, my favorite band at the time. So we bonded a lot over Van Halen music. I went and saw a ton of Van Halen shows over the time that we spent a lot of time together. And then the only other concert that I want to talk about was this one. And we did go and see the Grateful Dead twice. I'm definitely not a Grateful Dead fan, but I'm not going to talk about the Grateful Dead, actually. We went to Pittsburgh to see them. And if you remember, when we heard this song, Rusted Root, who was opening for them, we who had maybe had a beer or two heard this playing, and we started running next to a building with this big gravel embankment that I slipped and slid down face first and got covered in blood. And halfway through the Dead, we decided to drive back to Edinburgh. And apparently when I went to bathroom before I left was the first time I realized I was covered in blood. Kind of sums up that time period in our lives. So I'm going to end this talk with two songs. I'm not even going to explain either one. There's this one. Dumb. And then, of course, this one, your all-time absolute positive favorite song.
Mr. Lover, that girl is
Peace be. Happy birthday.
Hey, Brian. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday. We miss and love you.
We wish we were there with you tonight with all your buddies and friends and everything. And we hope you got some cool gifts.
Yes, we hope you got some cool gifts, like maybe some shoes.
Or a haircut.
A haircut, maybe a belt.
Or maybe an ass. Anyway, just kidding. We love you.
We love you the way you are.
And we'll see you real soon. Mwah, 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 mwah.
BTA, happy birthday, buddy. Man, thanks for everything. I wish we could hang out more. 45, bro. I'll see you soon. I remember those times in Lyons, and our first meeting at the Sundowner. It was a good time. Mr. McMurtry at the, wherever that was, on Pearl Street. Don't tell him we drank all that, what was it, Inkerstein? All right, brother. I love you. I want to see you soon. Take care, Brian. Happy birthday. Bye.
There, Mr. Boogers. Happy birthday.
Is Boogers a real thing?
So I went down to my hair cutter and I said, give me the Atkinson. I want the Atkinson. And this is what I came out with. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Brian, and your haircut. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Brian. You're a good one.
Happy birthday, Brian. You're getting old. It's time to start wearing shoes. I hope somebody bought you some, because I didn't get you shit. All right, peace.
It's like when you're making conversation and you're trying not to scream, and you're trying not to tell them that you don't care what they mean, and you're really feeling fragile and you really can't get home. Really feel abandoned, but you want to be alone. Old friends that shine like diamonds. Old friends you can always call. Old friends, Lord, you can't buy 'em. You know it's old friends.
Happy 45th birthday, Brian. I still remember the first time we met in the hallway at the Four Seasons when you were about to interview Christofferson. It seems like another lifetime ago. I'm really glad we're friends. I'm proud of all the work you've done. And here's to the next 45 years.
Hey, Brian. Happy birthday. You truly are one of the great music and literary innovators. God bless and take care, old friend. This is H.
I'll stay as long as the cuckoo wails and the lonesome blue jay cries. Close your eyes, I'll be here in the morning. Close your eyes, I'll be here for a while.
Brian, I hope you have a happy birthday, man. I knew you were a great writer and a great music reporter, but I had no idea you were so dang old, says the guy who's pushing 63. Happy birthday, man, and many happy returns, and many more books, I hope.
Hey, Brian. It's the ghost of Andy Warhol here. I'm filling in for the ghost of Towns Van Zandt, who got drunk and couldn't make it. He was filling in for your friend Tiffany, who's been sick all week and looks like death and didn't want to appear on camera. I don't blame her. But she wanted to wish you a very happy birthday. She says she's so glad that she has a friend who likes Towns Van Zandt even half as much as she does, and she hopes that your birthday is the very best. Cheers, man. Happy birthday.
I
I'm here to wish you happy birthday, Brian. I hear you're 45? You're 45 years old? Oh, man, that is old. Hey, happy birthday, Brian. Take care, man.
Greetings from Winnipeg, Manitoba, Canada. Happy birthday, Brian. Thank you for everything you do. Love and respect.
Brian, happy birthday. Thanks for all the great conversations, all the great ideas, all the great meals, all the great projects together. Thanks for helping me get this thing done. That very helpful pressure was a gift, and you are a gift. And so thanks for giving us you for your birthday so many years ago. Keep on. Love you. Bye.
Hi, Brian. Happy birthday from me and everybody at Old Settlers.
And you're 45? Holy Toledo. I can't remember when I was 45.
That may be a function of becoming 45.
Yeah, you lose your memory.
So, whatever, however this book goes, in a couple years, you won't remember it anyway.
All right, Brian. Well, happy birthday. We love you very much, and we can't wait to celebrate with you.
Yeah, and don't celebrate too much. Stay out of trouble.
Hey, Brian. I'm kind of hungover and sitting in this gas station parking lot in San Antonio recording this video because even though maybe you can be kind of a jackass, you're still one of the better people I know out there in the world, and I wanted to make sure to wish you a happy birthday. Hope you have a great 45th, you know, some more later too, but yeah, I hope it's a good one, and I'll see you sometime. Probably not soon, but soon-ish. All right, take it easy.
Everything is not enough. Nothing is too much to bear. Where you've been is good and gone. All you keep is the getting there. Where to live is to fly. Both low and...
Hey.
Sound good.
Thank you.
What you doing?
I'm making a video for Brian.
Oh. Hi, Brian. Happy birthday. I got you something. Where's my sandwich?
On a serious note, a person can't ask for a better friend than you be. We spent a lot of amazing times together way back in the day. I still look at you as a best friend, and I am so glad that you're there celebrating with so many amazing other friends. I can't be there, but sometime real soon, I'll see you in Austin. Happy 45th birthday, buddy. Talk to you soon. Peace.
Happy birthday, Brian! I hope you have a fun day full of lots of fun activities, including snow angels.
Happy birthday, Brian! I hope you're having a beautiful day. I hope that this year brings you so much love and joy and passion and creativity, and your book's going to be amazing, and you're just going to make so many good memories, and I hope I'm in some of them. So here's to a year of just great times, lots of love and fun. Okay, much love. Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Brian T. Atkinson. Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday, man. 45 is the new 40, I've heard. And I may or may not be in my underwear. Olaf from Nashville, I'll see you kids soon. Happy birthday, man.
Sorry. Hi, Brian. I have risen from my deathbed to wish you happy birthday. Happy birthday, Brian.
Trip around the sun.
Hi, Brian.
Happy birthday, dude.
We hope you have a wonderful day.
Yes.
We love you.
When Brian launched into his tennis career, his first tournament was a major disappointment, finishing second. His second tournament, a major triumph, beating, can you tell, his, by the expression, his best friend. And then, lists at the Summer Academy, his proudest accomplishment, which was winning a bowling tournament. Then, the great tennis star ends his career on a high note, posed with a racket, cool dude, ever with a poser. 1991,
Agassi,
the dude.
Don't tell them to blow up on Olivet.
Must have been cold there in my shadow to never have sunlight on your face. You were content to let me shine, that's your way. You always walked a step behind.
Did you ever know that you're my hero? You're everything I wish I could be. I could fly higher than an eagle. 'Cause you are the wind beneath my wings.
Happy birthday, Brian!
Rain.
Saying to us, it's been a while since we broadcast online.
Yes.
We?
You?
I never broadcast online. Mm-hmm. What are the broadcasts?
Who's this?
Your concert window.
Oh my gosh. Yes?
Why is it saying that to me?
I don't know.
I never did broadcast online. It's not been a while, it's been forever.
Snow angels. If you grew up in PA or listened to Dr. T, you would know exactly what this is. You do not do either. So you don't know this is the fucking snow angel. Rain.
First time I heard Peggy Sue, I was 12 years old. Russians up in rocket ships and the war was cold. Now many wars have come and gone, genocide still goes on, Buddy Holly still goes on, but his catalog was sold. First time I smoked, guess what? Paranoid. First time I heard Satisfaction, I was young and unemployed. Down the decades every year, summer leaves and my birthday's here, and all my friends stand up and cheer and say, man, you're old, getting old, you're old, you're getting old. We celebrate the birth of Jesus on Christmas Day, and Buddha found nirvana along the Lotus Way. About 1500 years ago, messenger Muhammad spoke, and his wisdom like a river flowed through hills of gold. Wisdom is old, the Quran is old, the
the Bible is old, greatest story ever told. Disagreements, work them out. The human race has walked the earth for 2.7 million, and we estimate the universe about 13, 14 billion. When all these numbers tumble into your imagination, consider that the Lord was there before creation. God is old, we're not old. God is old, he made the mold. Take your clothes off, Adam and Eve.
It's full of great tips for your online concert. My online concert.
Oh! Are you videotaping this bullshit? What's wrong with you?